Let's assume that you want to send a message from Atlanta to San Francisco. And to make it easier, let's assume that we want to send a simple message which consists of 10 coin flips or the output of 10 coin flips. Let us construct two messages out of coin flips. Now, I have two coins, but you see these coins are different because this one has a heads and a tails. It's at two different sides. And this one has both the sides, which are very similar looking. So it's a biased coin. So every time I flip, it's always going to have the same state. While when I flip this, it might either end up here 50% of the times or end up here 50% of the time. So we'll construct two messages after flipping both of them and recording what their state is. So here it is. I did 10 coin flips. With the fair coin, I got a few heads, a few tails in this particular sequence. With the unfair coin, I'm calling every state as a head state, and I basically saw 10 heads, right? If you also observe the fair coin, I have like 5 heads and 5 tails. So the probability, so it is a fair coin. I got 5 heads and 5 tails, so it is a fair coin. So if I had to transmit this sequence, how many bits of message will I require? Let's assume that I can represent this sequence using 10 binary digits. A 0 representing heads, 1 representing tails, and I can write down this sequence as zeros and ones using 10 bits. I can also write down the same sequence with the unfair coin using those 10 binary digits. So I'll get something like 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1. Here, everything will be zeros. Now let's assume I have to transmit this two particular sequences from Atlanta to San Francisco. What will be the size of each message in case of the fair coin and the unfair coin? What do you think? Write down your answers here.